a new underwater drone that resembles one of the most beautiful creatures in the ocean has been unveiled. The Manta Ray UUV, built by Northrop Grumman, is built to perform military missions. The UUV, conceptualized by the Defense Advanced Projects Research Agency, or DARPA, has been 4 years in the making and is capable of harvesting energy from the seas. Manta Ray was initiated in 2020 to create a new category of unmanned underwater vehicles, UUVs, capable of long-duration, long-range missions with significant payload capacity. The aim also involves enabling underwater operations with minimal human intervention. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Manta Ray UUV could be an excellent addition to the U.S. Navy. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Northrop Grumman states, "We developed our unique full-scale demonstration vehicle using several novel design attributes that support DARPA's vision of providing groundbreaking technology to create strategic surprise." The company adds that it is payload capable to support a variety of missions, and it will be autonomous so it can operate without the need for on-site human logistics. Manta Ray will have an energy-saving mode with the ability to anchor to the seafloor and hibernate in a low-power state. It will also be modular, enabling easy shipment in 5 standard shipping containers to support expeditionary deployment and in-field assembly worldwide. Autonomous low-power, high-efficiency propulsion is not easy to achieve, and hence DARPA has taken inspiration from nature. For example, traditional propellers can get damaged very easily due to the presence of different types of living and non-living elements, and this is not best for efficiency. The Manta Ray UUV is essentially biomimicry. Viewers may note that the streamlined body shape of a Manta Ray facilitates highly efficient underwater propulsion, enabling these large creatures to effortlessly glide through the water using slow, graceful movements of their wing-like fins. This gliding technique helps them conserve energy and optimize their movement efficiency. Such effectiveness in swimming has led to minimal evolutionary changes in rays over the past 100 million years. AI will be used so that no human intervention is needed. The command and control capabilities that DARPA could build into Manta Ray UUV means the system could learn over time. This means that it will get better in its tasks. Importantly, Manta Ray UUV will need to use minimal amounts of energy, as well as harvest energy from the sea, so that it has almost unlimited endurance and range, and size can be kept small. There are 2 ways to address the energy issue. One option is solar power, where batteries recharge from a solar array, ideally integrated into the drone structure. However, sunlight diminishes rapidly as it penetrates deeper into the ocean, necessitating the drone to ascend to the surface for battery charging, thereby increasing its vulnerability to detection. Second is the use of wave energy. In a DARPA video from 2022, the drone showcases what seems to be a deployable wave energy harvesting device, converting water movement into electricity. This feature enables the drone to remain submerged on the ocean floor, recharging its batteries discreetly and minimizing the risk of detection by adversaries. Such autonomy in mission execution, without the requirement of refueling, presents a plethora of opportunities. Presently, the Navy depends on dedicated surface vessels and certain stationary hydrophone arrays for submarine tracking. However, these ships are susceptible to attacks, and would likely need to be withdrawn during wartime. For hydrophone arrays, once the location of the arrays is identified, they become targets for potential destruction. This is where Manta Ray can come into the picture. In the future, the Navy may deploy a fleet of Manta Rays outfitted with hydrophones, perhaps in the South China Sea. This deployment would enable continuous monitoring of Chinese surface warships and submarines as they transition between the coverage areas of different Manta Rays. The real Manta Ray may be a peaceful creature of the seas, but its robotic counterpart has the potential to be a lethal offensive option. An alternative mission could involve anti-submarine warfare. While certain mantas might be tasked with locating and monitoring enemy submarines, others could carry armaments, such as the Mark 46 lightweight anti-submarine torpedo, and deploy them upon confirming the presence of an enemy sub within range. Mark 46 has a range of 11 kilometers, or about 7 miles, a speed of 74 kilometers per hour, or 46 miles per hour, and can operate at a maximum depth of 1,200 feet, or 370 meters. A fleet of mantas could develop into a fluid anti-submarine network, independently relocating between areas and holding enemy submarines at risk. As per the released 2022 edition of the Chief of Naval Operations Navigation Plan, the U.S. Navy plans to expand the overall force from approximately 300 combat ships to 523. Importantly, of those, 150 ships are intended to be uncrewed. So there is a concerted effort toward having an autonomous fleet that's distributed and cost-efficient. Manta Ray UUV is aligned with that concept. Also, it must be noted that, as evident from the Ukraine-Russia conflict, asymmetric warfare is critical. During the night of January 31st to February 1st, 2024, a daring operation conducted by Group 13 of the Special Intelligence Unit of the Ukrainian Ministry of Defense took out the Russian Black Sea Fleet's corvette Ivanovets. The attack took place at the roadstead of the Lake Danuzlav in Crimea, which is currently occupied by Russia. The Ukrainian Military Intelligence Directorate, GRU, announced that it has carried out this operation using a group of unmanned boats. It's clear that evolving technologies enable new-age smaller assets to take on much larger traditional platforms in certain scenarios. It'll be interesting to observe how the Manta Ray UUV program takes shape.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.